Welcome and thank you for joining the webinar today. I'm Amanda Jadro, the Director of Portfolio Management at TRICOM. As an administrative and financial solutions provider to the staffing and consulting industry, it is our philosophy to be an active member of the staffing industry by staying abreast of the ever-changing marketplace. For that reason, TRICOM was pleased to launch the Industry Insider webinar series designed to share our expert knowledge and resources with our fellow staffing industry colleagues. One of our core values is to build relationships and become a leading resource to staffing and consulting firms nationwide. Our presenter today is Andre Young, founder of You Evolving Now. Andre is a professional speaker, author, leadership trainer, and founder of Evolving Now, LLC. He worked as a mental health therapist for 19 years, played sports at every level from high school to professional, has been an employee, a business owner, and self-employed. Written four books focused on enhancing leadership and work-life harmony. As founder of You Evolving Now, it's his mission to enhance leadership and work-life harmony for organizations, leaders, employees, and teams with his high-energy, interactive, culture-changing leadership training programs and speaking engagements, allowing a professional and personal evolution. Evolve your company, your employees, and your work culture. In today's Industry Insider webinar with Andre, we'll have a high energy, interactive, and culture changing training. This presentation focuses on management and employees enhancing leadership skills, personal leadership, work culture, and work-life harmony for themselves, their teams, and the organization. Today, we're gonna talk about a couple of different points. One is the 5 points of your day, leaders using their time differently, construction talk, how to gossip, vent, and share an idea like a leader, a leader's burnout, how to prevent or lead through burnout. By the end of the session, you'll be energized and equipped with practical tools to both evolve personally and professionally. If you have questions during the presentation, please utilize the chat feature. With this, we're gonna turn the floor over to Andre and let him take us from here.
Well, thank you so much, Amanda. Hi, everyone. Happy Thursday. I hope that everybody's having an amazing day, and I look forward to making it even a bit better with what I get to share with you today. I was beyond honored that TRICOM reached out and asked if I can do this webinar today, and I jumped at the chance. So a big thank you to Amanda, to Shelley, to TRICOM, and to everyone on the call today for allowing me to steal an hour or so out of your busy, busy day. So I know you're busy, so daggone it, I better be good. As Amanda mentioned, welcome to Evolve Your Leadership in 3. Today I have 3 tips that I believe and I know that will help enhance not only your leadership and work-life harmony, but also that of those that you are leading. So we are going to talk about the 5 points of your day. You want to live the life of your dreams, professionally and personally. I'm going to show you the foundation of how to do it. We're going to be talking about that construction talk because success and leadership are a language, and leaders speak better than everyone else. They also bounce back quicker than everyone else. And we're going to talk about how to best do that. And then lastly, through burnout. No matter how great you are leading or we are leading, some of us, all of us, we are not exempt from burnout. So I want to share with you a formula that will help prevent it or best lead through it. So I see the chat over here. I am not going to be a talking head this whole hour. This is a power hour, and I have a lot to give. And after I share, I want to ask you, what was your biggest takeaway? Put it in the chat. It's so important that we hear it, that you say it. Because after we click off this call, life is waiting to butt punch you with all of the emails that you just missed for the past hour, your kids and about to get ready to go to practice and here and there and all around the world. Your phone is going to be buzzing and ringing. And if you don't know what you took from this, this runs the risk of simply being entertaining and not of value and impact moving forward. So guys, if you would like to put your camera on, I love seeing faces. I love seeing eyeballs. So please feel free to do that if you like. If not, I completely understand. And we are about to jump into it today. But before that, who the heck am I? And why should you be listening to me anyway? Yes, Amanda mentioned that I'm a professional speaker, author, leadership trainer, and founder of You Evolving Now. But more importantly, as an ex-employee, I was the world's best employee at one point in my life, says me. I was also the world's worst employee at one point of my life, says me, due to burnout. And although I was so right about every single thing that I was saying, guys, I was so wrong about how often I was saying it, who I was saying it to, and how I disconnected from my team, my people, my passion because of it. I was also elevated to positions of management and made all of the rookie manager mistakes because we all manage before we know how to lead. Then I was elevated to a position of leader, and I did so in my own company, having staff, then doing it remotely worldwide. So I want to share everything that I share is going to be coming from those two lenses. So let's jump in with the 5 points of your day. I want to ask you a question, and it's not rhetorical. You can put it in the chat if you like, but I think I know the answer. Can you please say yes in the chat if you would like to live the life of your dreams, both professionally and personally? Put yes in the chat or do a hand raise, and I love to see how many yeses we can get. All right, I see it, Steve, Nicole, Scott, I see them all coming in. Now, it sounds like an odd question, but I must say I was spent 19 years as a mental health therapist, and not everybody responds yes to that question. But that's a whole different training. So since you guys all said yes, here's the 5 points of the day. You do it starting right now, it will work quickly, and you do it consistently, it'll work for the rest of your life, I promise. Here's point number one. You want to live the life of your dreams. Point number one is what we consume when we wake up in the morning. Guys, I hear so many leaders, so many noble leaders, that they wake up and the first thing they do is grab their phone, take it to the bathroom with them, and start checking emails. Want to hate your job in 5 years? Want to struggle with your coworkers and employees? Do that every day and see how you feel. Now, do not get fired or in trouble because Andre Young told you not to check your emails. What I'm saying is it may not have to be the first thing that you check. I do this worldwide, and in my home, all of a sudden I'm an idiot and nobody listens to me. You may have that same issue. Now, my wife, every morning, I see her every morning. She gets out the shower, she goes to dry her hair, and her hair is almost touching the floor. And she's looking at her emails while she's drying her hair. And like whack-a-mole, about every 2 to 3 minutes, she pops up, and this is what happens. Oh, that's so dumb. Ooh, why would somebody email me that? Or that's so stupid. Now, I can hear you guys giggling over the phone because I see it every day and I giggle. Be mindful that the first things you're putting in your mind are making you better instead of bitter. So maybe you choose to watch me. You can go to YouTube or wherever on social media I am, and you can listen to a motivational teacher, not a speaker, teacher, something that gives you input, something that makes you better. Maybe it's like you need that cup of morning coffee before you bite people's head off. Maybe it's you're doing push-ups. Maybe it's you want to watch the sunrise. Whatever it is it making you better instead of bitter? Some people turn on the news first thing in the morning. And if you've ever watched the first 10 minutes of the news, you know there is no good news. The sky's always falling. Maybe you're picking up your phone. And you know who knows you better than anyone on this planet? Your phone. Your phone is going to give you what you like and subscribe to on a loop without a commercial break. So be mindful. So be mindful of what you consume in here and here before you start your day. Point number two is organize your day. When you get to where you have chosen to be, whether it's physically to work or to your laptop and you're going to open it up, I encourage you very much so to have your notebook. And you want to write down your list of things you get to do that day. Now, mindful of language, I didn't say have to do. There's about 8 billion people on this planet. And please keep in mind that more than half of them will trade places with you right now. They'll take everything that you complain about. They'll take your job, your car, your paycheck. I see that. And they'll take everything else. So it's get to do. So keep that list. Type A people, raise your hand that likes crossing things off of list. I'm one of them. Be mindful with your list. The pro of having a list is that you get to cross it off, and it feels good that you're crossing things off. The concern about the list is that you know, like I know, that the list never stops growing. It will keep growing and multiply and trickle on to the next page. So to make your list impactful, at the top of your page, I want you to start writing the word wins. W-I-N-S, wins. What are your wins going to be for the day? I know my list of get-to-dos are about 15 to 20 things long to effectively run my business and company every day. However, my wins are usually 1 to 3 things. Be sure that if anything gets crossed off your list, daggone it, your wins do. It will change the way you see your day. Do you know your wins? Do you know the wins of your direct report, of your people, your team? Do they? The second part of organizing your day is please organize who the heck we, you, I choose to hang around when we get to work. You know the negative Nicks and Nancys, the water cooler conversation people, the people that are gossiping about everything. As a leader, we walk in and we smile and we give the Queen's wave to everyone. But we don't stop and park it with everyone. Be mindful. Point number three is relationship building and self-care. If you're writing this down, I'm going to say it again. Relationship building and self-care. At some point in the day, we're all going to hit a wall. And whether that's your 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, it's coming. Maybe you're smacking it right now. Self-care means you'll remember to do something for you. And it may mean you remember to eat. In my employee days, you could not pry my half-hour lunch period out of my cold, dead hands. I was going to have my lunch. However, having my own business, I love what I do so much that dang one that I'll forget to eat. So maybe self-care means you remember to eat. Maybe you remember to eat healthy. Maybe you take a walk. Maybe you eat lunch with somebody else and plan a lunch date. Whatever it is, make sure you put self-care in your schedule, put an alert to it, and be good to you. Now, what do I mean about relationship building? Can you please put in the chat? Do you have someone on this planet that you love and care about? Put a yes if you do. Yes with an exclamation point even. Yes, yes. Ben, Jasmine, Brianne, Mike. You have somebody on this planet you love and care about. Great for you. What would it take to send that person or people a text to say, Hey, I was just thinking about you. I hope you're having an amazing day. Hey, it's been a while since we caught up. Thank you for everything that you do. Guys, my wife works right upstairs. She is literally right upstairs right now. COVID living, right? And every now and then I'll send her a text and say, "Hey, beautiful, I hope your day is going as amazing as you are. I love you. Can't wait to see you." Let me tell you, that sets up the second half of my day really nicely. Also, it's not simply what it does for her, it's also what it does for me. See, as a former therapist, I can sum up therapy in 30 seconds for you. What you think about and speak about all day impacts how you feel, then what you do, and then your consequences thereafter, either negative or positive. So when you speak good, you feel good, you do good, you get good consequences, and vice versa. My mom passed away 2 years ago. You know what I give to send her one more text? And I know that we all have the fastest thumbs on the planet. That text takes you, what, 20 seconds? Do you know how you would feel if you got a text like that right now from your significant other, your kids, your parent, your best friend? Be sure, as a leader, you're giving that gift to the special people in your life. Next point. Point number four, how we return home. Thank you so much. That's so powerful. I appreciate that. Point number four, how we return home. I'm going to ask a question here, and you can put it in the chat, your answer. As a leader at an organization, would you ever intentionally hire someone that would be looking as if they'd rather be anywhere else, dragging themselves around, TGIFing Monday through Thursday, and complaining about everything? Would you intentionally hire this individual? No, big no with caps. No. Now, some people can slip through the cracks. Don't get me wrong. Most grouches become grouches. You didn't hire them that way. So since we all agree we would never hire this person, isn't it so sad that that's how most of us return home? That's how most of us shut down the laptop after work and walk back into the living room, kicking in the door. You wouldn't believe this. You wouldn't believe that. To the point where your family might have to scatter. They don't know which way to go because mom or dad is coming. Now, I hear some of you giggling because I know some of us come home that way. And I'm telling you right now, as a leader, that that has to stop. It is our job as leaders to walk through that door the same way you would want your employees showing up to work. With a smile, ready, and I call it the three P's: positive, passionate, productive. Now, how do we do that? How do we do that? We have to know what it takes for you to do that. For me, years ago, it was going to the gym. And my kids would say, "Oh, I don't want to. I don't like the gym. I don't want to go to the daycare." And I'm like, "Look, we got that. Daddy's about to." Now, I'm not condoning strangling your kids. Do not strangle your kids. When you have kids, you know what I mean. That hour at the gym was 1 hour where it was all about me. My phone didn't have to ring, no emails, no text messages. I could listen to music. I could speak to my gym family. It was all about me. And then I could come back and put my cape on and I could be dun, 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 Superman, super husband, super dad, and I have my second win. Maybe for you, it's coming home and taking a shower and washing the day off, taking a walk around the block. Whatever it is you choose to do, here's the tip. Because without the tip, it may be a bigger issue. Explain to the people in your life, if there's a significant other or kids, what you want to do, why you're doing it, how it's going to make you better for them and in the house, And it is our job as leaders to come back so daggone good from it that the people in your life daggone it give you permission to go do it. Hey, go to the gym. I like how you are when you come back from that thing. Hey, go to girls' night. I like how you are when you come back from that thing. Be so great coming back. Be so impactful and valuable and positive and passionate and productive that the people in your life give you permission to go do it. The final point, point number five. I want to teach you the greatest question a human being can ask themselves. At the end of the night, now I do 5 days a week. You can do seven if you like. But from now on, at the end of the night, before you close your eyes to go to bed, I very quietly want you to ask yourself this. What was my biggest accomplishment of the day? It is a simple yet powerful question that I'm going to tell you your brain is so fast, you're going to have an answer. But without asking the question to yourself, I hear from so many people and so many women that they lay in bed at night and all they can think is about all the things they didn't get done today and all of the things that they have to do tomorrow. Do that for a year, 5 years, a decade. How are you supposed to feel about you and your life, professionally and personally? Having an answer to this question will allow you to have won the day instead of another day kicking your butt. And your brain moves so fast. Do you know what you have accomplished by your 2 o'clock, my 3 o'clock here today? You're going to have more than one answer. And you get to give yourself that pat on the back for being as great as you are. You want to take it a step further. Ask that person sleeping next to you. Ask your kids that are down the hall. If you ask them what their biggest accomplishment was today, they have an answer. They have an answer. And it's typically an answer that you don't know. My wife works in land development. I usually have no idea what she's talking about. But now I know what to congratulate her for and hug her for things outside of being my wife. So guys, that's the 5 points of your day. What you consume when you wake up, organizing your day, midday self-care and relationship building, how we return home, and your big accomplishment question of the day. I promise you do this consistently. Watch what happens to your life. That's enhancing work-life harmony. So I want to be quiet for a second because I want to ask you guys, and in the chat, what point stood out for you? What point resonated with you and said, oh, I felt that, and that's something that I know I'm going to work on because that was me? Put it in the chat. I'd love to hear from you. How to return home. Scott, hey Scott, how are you? What we consume wins for the day. Self-care, all of them, is awesome. Walking through the door, the three P's. Yes, we're gonna talk a little bit more about that. Self-care. You know, I biggest accomplishment, I worked in mental health for 19 years, and I will tell you some of the people who take care of themselves the least are the people that take care of everybody else. Be sure that self-care is a priority for you because it will enhance your leadership and work-life harmony and that of those that you are leading. Thank you, Nicole. Okay, we're gonna go into tip number two. And I'm going to leave some time at the end if you guys have some questions. I'm not in a rush to leave, but if you have to go at the end, I understand. Let's get, now that we know a little bit more about how to lead ourselves personally and work-life harmony, let's get into construction talk. Remember, I said leadership and success are a language, and leaders speak differently from everyone else. So at the foundation of this is how you choose, how we as leaders choose to show up to our life, our work, and our relationships in a way that makes people want to follow us because they enjoy how we are and who we are. They may not like every decision that we make, but they cannot deny the respect that they have for us. One of the rules that I have for myself is I don't hire, I don't outsource with, and I do not hang out with anyone that's not the three P's. You have to be positive, passionate, and productive. One without the other two is always going to be a nightmare. You can't have you yourself or someone else being productive, but how they're productive is backstabbing, lying, and cheating and negative. You can't have someone that's positive standing in the corner smiling and not getting anything done. And you can't have somebody that's passionate but ignorant to the job and doesn't know or being negative. All three P's work together. So how do we start speaking like a leader? Number one is gossip, a leader's gossip. Now, I am so against negative gossip. Dave Ramsey, if you know who he is, he's the financial mogul and he teaches people how to do their finances. I saw a video and he has a two-strike rule. If he catches you gossiping one time, two times, you're fired. No ifs, ands, or buts. He does not do gossip. I'm encouraging everyone on this call to gossip, but I want you to do good gossip. Now, I want to say, be honest, good gossip travels slower than bad gossip, but it still travels. Be mindful as a leader to gossip good about your job, good about your position, good about your bosses, good about your employees and coworkers. So when we do that and we gossip good in our workplace, on our Zoom calls, in our emails, it may never get back to us, but when it does, it will be good. For example, I saw Scott. I know Scott. Scott, you're amazing. Happy Thursday. But if I would use Scott as an example, and Amanda is such a great host, if I would say, hey, Amanda, have you ever got a chance to talk to Scott? He is so sharp. He really is on his stuff. If you get a chance to talk to him, you really should. Look at what that does for every party involved. One, it makes me feel good. I spoke good, now I feel good, now I'm doing good, and only good things can come back to me. It makes Amanda feel good because now she may be getting information. You don't know what Amanda may have felt about Scott. Maybe Amanda hated Scott's guts. I'm just joking. Amanda doesn't dislike anybody. But maybe I just gave her some information of where to go, what to get, and changed her perception of a coworker. And if and when that information ever gets back to Scott, how do you think Scott's going to feel about it? You take this same example when you're out to dinner, you're at the grocery store. Speak good about your office. Speak good about your job. Speak good about the product that you supply to the world. You never know who's listening. You're out to eat, and then the waitress comes over and says, you know, my son, I literally have a 20-year-old son looking for work. My son is looking for work, and I overheard you speaking so good about the job. Where exactly is this, and are you guys hiring? Things like that happen all the time. I fly around the country, the world, doing this, and people come up to me and say, oh, I'm actually flew in for your event to hear you speak. How would I have looked if I was having a fit with the airline stewardess? Doesn't look good. So be mindful to gossip good about all the things you get to have and enjoy professionally and personally, and watch what happens. The next is a leader's vent. Now, I will be honest, we are all human beings. And no matter how good you gossip, and how good of a leader we are, at some point, you're going to get ticked off. At some point, something professionally or personally is going to grind your gears, and you're going to need to vent. And venting isn't the worst thing in the world, depending on how we do it. Leaders vent differently from everyone else. This is how most people vent. Whatever they're upset about, anyone and everyone that comes within their 18 inches of personal space will get the story. I once worked in my employee days with a woman, and she came in and she told every single person that stepped inside her bubble that story. Do you think she can skip back home to everything she complained about for 8 hours and love it? You tolerate it. Do you think you can speak poorly about your job all day and then skip to it and love it a day from now, 5 years from now? Leaders vent differently from everyone else, and here's the vent rule. One, it needs to be people limited. Who are your people? We have to be mindful and beware of the bobbleheads. The bobbleheads is everybody that you could call. You know them. You know them. They're in your phone right now. You could call them up. You could call up a coworker. You could go to somebody's office and close the door, and a 5-second conversation turns into a 1-hour vent session. And that bobblehead sits there and tells you how right you are. Oh, yep, you're so right. And if I was you, I'd do this. Only to send you back more righteously wrong to the situation. So as a leader, who are your people? Leaders never vent down. Yes, there's a hierarchy at a job. Leaders don't vent down. And if you're going to vent laterally or up, you vent to someone that can help you. So who are your people? Maybe it's somebody at work. Maybe it's a trusted friend or parent. Maybe it's a pastor. Whoever it is, it can't be everybody. Number two, it has to be time limited. Venting isn't supposed to happen all day or for an hour. You get it out. Get it out. And then lastly, it has to be purposeful. If you and us as leaders or the people you're venting to don't say, okay, now what? What is your position? Why did that other person do or say what they said? They're not the worst person in the world bursting out of the underbelly of society to take you down. That's not typical. So they do have a point. What's their point? And what are you going to do about it? Regardless of how they respond, regardless if you get what you want, what's right? What will you do about the issue that enhances your leadership and work-life harmony and potentially theirs? A leader's vent. Next is a leader's idea. As a leader's idea, I'm about to share my screen with you in a bit, but let me share a leader's idea. Leaders share their ideas differently from everyone else. And I came up with the best way I've found to do it over the years, both professionally or personally, and it sounds like this. Amanda, I'll use your name as an example again. Or Nicole, we'll switch it up. Hey, Nicole, you have a second? Hey, I have an idea I think will help with dot, dot, dot. I would love to hear what you like about it or anything you would fine tune or change about it. That's it. The flow of it is, number one, I want to respect Nicole's time. Hey, Nicole, do you have a second? Number two, hey, I have an idea I think will help with this. So my idea is going to help with a specific problem. Next is, I would love to hear what you like about it. Always make somebody say something good about your idea first. And then, is there anything you would fine tune or change? See, fine tune is an evolving word because it means your idea is good enough already. However, you're willing to remove your ego and invite the other person's in to make it better. I've done this in business. I encourage my employees and people I outsource with to do it with me. And I also do it with my wife. 2 years ago, I said, hey, honey, I think I have an idea for vacation. I really want to go to Ocean City, Maryland. I'd love to hear what you like about it, anything you would change about it. And my wife looked at me and said, I like the idea of the beach. At that time, our youngest daughter is 2 years old. And she said, I'd rather hear a baby cry for 2 hours and not 4 hours. So maybe Ocean City, New Jersey. I said, fine, book it. So it's the format of the question. How we share an idea. Too many times, great ideas are left on the floor and don't get to grow wings because of poor delivery. Now that leads us to the last part of construction talk, and it's called a leader's blueprint. I want to share my screen with you so you can take some of these things down, because as a leader, I truly believe it's that important. So if someone can give me a thumbs up or a yes that you can see what I'm looking at here, see the screen. Awesome, thank you. All right, so a leader's blueprint is this. I have been shocked that so many leaders say they have an open door policy and they want their people to come and challenge them, share their ideas with them. And in that open door policy, no one's walking through. When nobody's coming to your office with their ideas, something's up. And I'm not saying that you are a bad leader. Sometimes maybe we're inaccessible. Maybe we look so busy that they don't want to come. Maybe they don't know when to come. A lot of times, we don't know what our employees and direct reports have been through before working with and for you. I get to speak worldwide to C-suite, middle management, and frontline. And I've had some frontline and middle managers say that they are gun shy because they've been professionally abused at other organizations. They've gotten their heads bitten off. They've been told that they were stupid or dumb. And I can share some words, but I don't like speaking like that, that they've also been told and called. So many times we assume as leaders that our people know that they can come to us, but we have ineffectively giving them the blueprint of how to approach us. You're a leader of your life professionally and personally. Have we given our people the blueprint of how to approach us with ideas and hard to hear information? And here it is. Number one, when we share these blueprints with our people, my question for you is, how do you best want to be approached? What's the method that you prefer? Maybe it's by email. Maybe it's by Slack. Maybe it's to your work phone. Maybe it's the old school knock at the door. Do your people know the method of how you want to be approached? For me, it's email. I'm a chatty Carl. You have chatty Cathy's and chatty Carl. Sometimes when I work physically in a building, that 5-minute conversation can take too long because I like to talk and then they start talking and all of a sudden you do that 3 times. That's 3 hours of my day. Gotta know yourself. My least favorite way is when I was an employee or a leader in an organization was for somebody to contact me via my work phone. I am the least effective leader with a work phone. I had an iPhone, they gave me a Samsung or an Android. Now I got to learn how to text this and hit this button and don't. Then I half the time didn't know where it was. I will get fired from a job if I ever had a work phone. So please know what method you prefer and share it with your people. Next, how do you prefer to hear it? What's the first words or sentence your people can say and that you know that they mean business and they have your attention? Professionally for me, my people know to say, hey, I have an idea that I think would help with this. Really love to know what you like about it, anything you would fine tune or change. Got me. My wife and my kids know that all they have to do is say, hey, Dre, you got a second? Hey, Dad, you have a second? I want to talk to you about something. I will stop the world from spinning. I will hit mute on the TV, and if it's really serious, let me get a cigar and a drink, because I've never been upset with a cigar and a drink in my hand. Know yourself. Number three is, what information do you need? This is how to come to me. This is the method. This is what you can start off your sentences with. And please bring me some suggested solutions. What do you need? One of my big rules is please accompany your problem with a suggested solution. One of three things is going to happen. Your idea is so daggone good, we have to go with it. Two, we might fine tune or collaborate because maybe you haven't seen the bigger picture or sat in my seat. Or this is not fitting the vision and vision factors for where we're going professionally. So on your time, can you fit your idea into that? Number four is, what's the next steps? Your person just came to you the exact way you asked. What's going to be your next step? Will you follow up, follow through? What authority are you going to give them? What's their authority span to now go run with the idea? So guys, that's the blueprint. Now you can change the wording to make it fit best your life, but it's the blueprint. And now this enhances your leadership and work-life harmony, and it also increases theirs because now they're less stressed, less anxious, and now they have to enhance their leadership by coming to you with it. So guys, that's the leader's blueprint. I like to be quiet for a second and ask you guys again in the chat. We just talked about a leader's gossip, a leader's vent, a leader's idea, and the leader's blueprint. It's a lot of information in a little bit of time. What was your biggest takeaway from that? Put it in the chat. Love to hear from you guys. Now, to leave some time. Perfect. The leader's idea. I see it. I see it. Gossip. Game changer. Thank you, Ben. More mindful. Awesome. Jen, gossip as well. Being mindful with language. The leader's blueprint. Awesome, guys. You keep them coming. The last point, the last tip, because I want to leave some time for questions at the end, is burnout. As I mentioned, we are all susceptible to it. I never thought that I would burn out of a job. My passion, my dream, that's what I wanted to do. It's what I studied. I was a nerd about it. I encourage everybody on the call, be a nerd about your craft. And it's a sad day when you know that you are burning out or have burnt out of it. So when this, if this happens to you, here's my formula for it. One, we need to be able to marry your why. I'm assuming that your employer is not waking you up at gunpoint and dragging you into your job every day. If that is happening, please contact your HR department immediately. That is not supposed to be happening. So since we can all agree that that is not the case, you're showing up every day to a job you are burning out from, relationship you may be burning out from, please marry your why. Why are you still there? It may be as simple as I need a check once every 2 weeks and that's happening. It may be that this is my craft and my passion and I like my team, but I don't like where we're going. It may be that they're paying for school. Whatever it is, marry your why. And once you have married your why, that can change over time. Your why is allowed to change over time. But once you marry it, we stop complaining. We stop negative gossiping about it. And we get positive, passionate, and productive since we're going to show up. Number two, know what's expected. As you are burning out, sometimes, and this is happening worldwide, organization-wide, people are stuck on the old way. Well, this isn't the way we used to do it. We never had to do it this way. Sometimes what you used to do is no longer what's needed. Change happened and leaders adapt and evolve. So please understand and know what's needed from you right now. What does your boss, your team, your customer, your client need most from you right now? Leadership is about creating a marriage. Marrying what you want to do and give with what the person receiving your effort needs most from you right now. So what does your boss need from you most right now? Your team, the company, your employers, your husband, your wife, your kids, when you can marry what you want to do and give with what they need most and do it a little bit outside of your comfort zone, but not so much you wind up bitter and resentful. That's the magic. That's the magic. You find purpose in your burning out. Point number three, enhance your superpower. You do something great. Know what your superpower is. I was speaking at an organization a few months ago, and I went around the room and I asked a woman, she was there, and I asked her what her superpower was. Now, I have five big superpowers that I talk about. I asked her which one she was, and she said, "I don't know." And when she was so confused, you could tell that she was upset with herself that she didn't know. And the next session that I came, she had an answer for me. She was so happy and proud to have had an answer. So what is your superpower? Be mindful that as you are going possibly through burnout, to enhance it. The average employee becomes worse. It becomes a liability. The great leader within you and leaders within organizations become assets. So whether you stay and overcome your burnout, you stay as an asset and not a liability. You decide to leave. You leave as an asset and not a liability. They're sad to see you go. They offer you more to have you stay. Maybe you take it or you don't. Asset, not a liability. Number four is network with the three P's. I don't have to say what they are again, but I will. Positive, passionate, and productive. Network with the three P's and not the bobbleheads at your level. At your professional level, above your level. And you can do that through emails and inviting people out to lunch or getting on a Zoom call to officially meet and say hello and how you doing. Is there anything you need from me? How do you best want me to come to you when I have an issue? Or this is the best way to come to me if you ever need anything from me in my department. And you can also network beyond. I am a member of 40 professional groups on LinkedIn. Do you know how many people out there hold your title? In Switzerland, in Australia, in Indiana? Network with those people. You never know what the next few years hold. And then lastly, vacations matter. Vacations are necessities, not luxuries. So whether you like cruising around the world, I do. I'm a big cruiser. But there was a time in my life where I didn't have the financial means to do so. So maybe binge watching Law and Order on a day off was the vacation. Whatever it is for you, leaders, especially through burnout, they take time and they make time for themselves and the people that matter in their lives. On a final note, as a leader, and this is particular for vacations, it is your job to sell your position. You cannot retire or take a day off or feel good leaving work when no one can do what you do, when nobody wants your position. Do you know how many leaders and noble employees don't take their vacation time? They're sending emails from the beach. They're at their kids' game doing work and on phone calls. Why would anybody receiving that call, those emails at 2 a.m., 11 p.m., why would any of them want to be your position one day? Your vacations matter. Enjoying them matters. How you come into work matters. Sell your position as a leader to enhance not only your leadership and work-life harmony, but also that of those that you are leading. So I want to ask, I'm going to share my screen one more time before we end. We talked about a lot of stuff in a power hour. We talked about the 5 points of your day. We talked about construction talk and all that goes into that. And we ended up on burnout. As we begin to close, I want to ask you, what homework are you going to give yourself that's going to enhance your leadership and work-life harmony now? Without an answer, busy is going to beat you. So in the chat, what's the one or two things? No one on this call is going to do every single thing that I said. But it is likely you're going to do the one thing that stood out for you. So what was that big takeaway and homework assignment you're going to give you, making you a better leader? Let's put it in the chat. And then we'll. I want to share my screen and then leave some time for questions. 5 points. Marry my why. Love it. Writing down the wins, getting caught up. Self-care, biggest accomplishment of the day. Love it. Construction talk, network with the three P's. That's huge. Positive. The wins. You guys are absolutely amazing. Keep them coming. And I cannot stress enough. Leaders don't lie to themselves. You wrote this down. This is important to you. Make sure you put it in your schedule. Do it consistently and watch what it does. I'm going to share my screen one more time. And this here is my page here. So you can go to the QR code. It will take you to my email address, website. The website, and youevolvingnow.com is my website. You can go there. There's free videos. There's my two books on leadership, 7 Ways to Lead. The Leader's Toolbox is there as well. There's some other different services that are there that you can check it out. There's an app that you can download and you get a question of the week, a quote of the week, a podcast of the month, and so much more. And last but not least, my email address. I love chatting with people, Zooming with people. So if you like to get on the chat, I would love to be able to set it up. My assistant, Nicole, will be happy to offer times and we can sit down and talk about your role, your team's concerns, and have a great conversation. So you can take a screenshot of this if you like. I'll leave this up for a couple more seconds so you can take a screenshot, get your phone out, take a pic. And lastly, love to thank TRICOM, Amanda, Shelley, everybody here on the call. You guys are absolutely amazing. Here's a screenshot. Please reach out to Amanda, TRICOM. You guys are absolutely awesome. Now, I'm going to be quiet for a minute because in wrapping up, do you guys have any questions for me? Amanda, I'm not sure if you want to click on or if there's any ones that come through that I can't see so I can answer without trying to read.
Sure. Yeah, there has been so much activity in the chat for this session. It's been wonderful to see the engagement. Keep that coming. Definitely reach out to Andre directly. Follow him on his social sites, his website. Always has really great information. Definitely recommend his books. I know several of us here at TRICOM are avid readers, and we absolutely love hearing Andre speak in webinars and podcasts. He's been at our conference here in Wisconsin for our clients. We absolutely love him. Your energy is infectious. It's been a wonderful program. You always have some really great tips for people to take away today, start using, making themselves better, both professionally and personally. Take away one tip and put it into practice, and you'll find that today was time well spent. Again, thank you so much for joining us today, and Andre for being a part of our webinar session this afternoon here.
It was a pleasure, and I see all of the awesome messages coming in. You guys are very welcome. I hope everybody has an awesome rest of the day. And as I mentioned, hey, please reach out. Go number 19. That's my son. He's a quarterback and doing very, very well. So thank you guys. And please reach out if you have any questions, concerns. I look forward to connecting with you.
Absolutely. Enjoy the rest of your day. Thanks, everyone.